بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. نبدأ بإذن الله تعالى بدراسة كتاب البيوع. نعم،
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. We're going to now start by studying the book of معاملات, which is the book of transactions.
نعم، أخذنا فيما تقدم أن الفقه ينقسم إلى قسمين. نعم.
We've already mentioned previously how fiqh is of two types.
عبادات ومعاملات، والمعاملات يلحق بها شيء. نعم.
Fiqh which relates to a person's عبادات, acts of worship, and the fiqh which relates to a person's transactions, and there's some overlap between both of them.
العبادات أركان الإسلام ومعها الجهاد. نعم.
So the ibadat are the pillars of Islam, including jihad.
كتاب الطهارة، شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله، طهارة الباطن قبل طهارة الظاهر. نعم.
So the book of الطهارة, purification, شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله, which includes the purification of persons inside, and then also we studied the physical purification.
ثم الصلاة.
And then after that the book of prayer.
ثم الزكاة. وقبل الزكاة ذكر نوع من أنواع الصلوات وهي الصلاة على الجنائز. وناسب أن يذكر هنا كتاب الجنائز. ثم بعد هذا كتاب الزكاة.
So then we come to the prayer, the book of prayer. After the book of prayer, there is the book of prayer upon the dead people, i.e. جنائز. So they mentioned the fuqaha, they mentioned the book of جنائز. After this, the book of zakat.
ثم كتاب الصيام.
And then the book of fasting.
ثم كتاب الحج.
And then the book of hajj.
ثم كتاب الجهاد. هذه العبادات.
And then after this the book of jihad, and this is now the section of عبادات.
نعم. المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى أن هذا الكتاب كتاب مختصر لم يذكر كتاب الجهاد. نعم.
And the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, Sheikh Sa'di, he didn't mention the book of jihad, and this is because this book, Manhaj al-Salikin, it's a very basic summarized book.
هو يؤلف لك.
So he's now, he authored this book for you.
أولا لابد من طهارة الباطن قبل طهارة الظاهر.
So you first have to purify yourself inside spiritually before you purify yourselves physically.
تطهر الباطن والظاهر.
So you purify both the inside and the outside.
تطهر تصلي.
Once you have purified yourself, then you pray.
ثم من الصلاة قلنا الصلاة على الجنائز.
And after you have prayed, then there is also a prayer upon for the funerals.
تؤدي الزكاة.
And then you give your zakat.
تصوم رمضان.
You fast Ramadan.
تحج.
You perform Hajj.
ثم يذكر لك الجهاد.
And then jihad is mentioned.
ثم أراد الآن أن ينتقل إلى القسم الثاني أن يذكر لك المعاملات.
And then after this, he wanted to go to the next subject area, which is transactions.
وما يلحق بها.
And also those things which are linked to transactions.
تبيع وتشتري.
You buy and you sell.
يبين لك هذا في البيوع.
So this chapter is covered by كتاب البيوع, the book of buying and selling.
باع الإنسان واشترى وحصل له شيء من المال.
Once a person has been trading and buying and selling, and he has now some wealth with him.
بعد هذا يكون النكاح.
Then he wants to get married.
وإذا كان النكاح لابد من عشرة النساء.
And if there is nikah, the next chapter that therefore we study is the book of nikah. Once there's nikah, then a person needs to know how to live with women and deal interact with women.
ثم بعد هذا يكون الطلاق.
And then after this there is divorce.
وإذا كان الطلاق هنا لابد عندنا من عدد، لأنه قد يموت أو يطلق فيذكر لك العدد. نعم.
And then after this, if there's talaq, if there's divorce, after the chapter of divorce, then there has to be waiting periods.
إذا حصل الطلاق في الغالب أن تكون هناك خصومة مع الزوجة وأهلها. نعم.
And if a divorce takes place, then in most cases there's usually disputes and problems between family members and the wife and husband.
فأذكر لك الحدود. أذكر لك الجنايات. نعم.
And then
يعني التعدي، يتعدى بقتل أو بجرح أو ما إلى ذلك. نعم.
And then because of this, the fuqaha, the next chapter that they mention is the chapter of various different crimes and oppression.
ثم بعد هذا يترافع إلى القضاء فيذكر لك القضاء.
And after this, once there's some oppression or violence, this case is taken up to the courts, and therefore the next book that is often mentioned is the book of Al-Qadha, which is judgment, so judging.
وبعد هذا أذكر لك الحدود.
And then after this, the next book that is mentioned is the book of punishments.
يذكر لك الأطعمة والأشربة والذبائح.
And also the book of food and drink and sacrifices mentioned.
ثم بعد هذا أن الإنسان باع واشترى وتزوج وطلق وقام بجنايات وقضي عليه بقضاء شرعي فماذا عليه الآن؟ عليه أن ينظر في نهاية هذه الحياة أن يختم الله سبحانه وتعالى له بماذا؟ بالإقرار. فناسب أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى يختم بالإقرار تفاؤلا أن الإنسان يخرج من هذه الدنيا بالإقرار بشهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبد ورسول، أو يختم بالعتق. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعتقنا وإياكم. نعم.
After now a person he's been buying and selling and accumulating wealth, he marries, intermarries with women, he divorces. There occurs disputes, crimes, there's a court case, and after there's eating and drinking and there's sacrifice. Then after this, the final chapter that the author mentions, the final chapter that the fuqaha mention, is iqrar. Iqrar كيف؟
Iqrar يعني قر يشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد عبد ورسول.
Iqrar meaning that a person accepts and bears witness that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the abd of Allah and his messenger.
نعم. أو يختم بعض الفقهاء بالعتق من النيران.
And some of the fuqaha they finish their books by mentioning al-itq, which is the book of emancipation, that a person is emancipated from the fire.
هذا محتوى الكتب التي هي مؤلفة على الفقه. نعم.
So this in most cases is an overview of most of the books when it comes to fiqh. Most of the books of fiqh are organized in this way.
الأصل في البيع الحل.
So the origin or the base ruling of buying and selling is that everything is permissible.
أي معاملة من المعاملات اختلفنا فيها فالأصل فيها الحل ومن يدعي التحريم يطالب بالدليل.
Any transaction, any type of buying and selling in which we differ over, is it permitted or is it not permissible? Then we say that the base ruling is that it is permissible. And the person who comes along and says that it is haram, then he is the one who has to provide the evidence.
هل يصح بيع هذه الأجهزة؟
Is it, for example, permitted in the Sharia to buy and sell these phones?
لم تكن زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Of course, at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, these things weren't available then.
بيع السيارات، الطائرات، القطارات.
Is it permissible for a person to buy and sell cars and trains and airplanes?
نقول الأصل الحل.
We say that the base ruling is that it is permissible.
والذي يدعي التحريم يطالب بالدليل.
And whoever now comes along claiming that it is haram, then he's the one who has to bring the evidence.
هذا عكس العبادات. الأصل في العبادات التحريم. أي إنسان يريد أن يأتي بعبادة نقول هذه العبادة حرام حتى تأتي بدليل عليها. نعم.
So this is the opposite to those issues relating to or to the rulings of worship. We say that the base ruling when it comes to worship and acts of worship is that it is haram. And therefore, if a person now comes along claiming that this worship is allowed, then he has to bring the evidence. So it's the total opposite to transactions and buying and selling.
شروط البيع.
What are the conditions of transactions and buying and selling?
لخص الشيخ الإسلام رحمه الله تعالى لنا شروط البيع أو الأمور التي إذا كانت في أي عقد من العقود يكون بها هذا العقد باطل ومحرم. نعم.
شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله, he has summarized for us the conditions of buying and selling. Or if a particular aspect is found in a contract of buying and selling, then the contract and that transaction is null and invalid.
ألا يكون في العقد ظلم.
That there should be no oppression in the contract.
أو غرر وجهالة.
And there should be no nothing which is unknown or something which is ambiguous in terms of what you're buying and selling.
أو ربا.
And there should be no riba, no interest.
هذه الشروط ثلاثة.
So these are the three conditions of the that a contract of buying and selling has to fulfill.
أي عقد من العقود تنظر فيه إذا خلا من هذه الأمور الثلاثة فهو صحيح في الغالب. نعم. الشرط الأول. نعم.
Any contract of transaction of buying and selling, as long as it fulfills these three conditions, i.e. doesn't include any of one of these three things, then in most cases, then the contract and the transaction is okay.
الظلم سيأتي معنا مثلا في الشركة. يقول هذا أنت لك ربح النهار وأنا لي ربح الليل. هذا فيه ظلم لأنه قد يكون ربح الليل أكثر أو النهار أكثر. نعم. إذن هذا العقد محرم. لماذا؟ لأنه هذا فيه ظلم. نعم.
So as an example or an example of oppression or ظلم that might occur in a contract of transaction and therefore it wouldn't be permissible is, for example, in a company. If you've got a partnership with somebody in a business and the person says, you can have the profit of the day and I'll take the profit of the night. This here now, it contains oppression in this transaction. Why? Because the profit in the day might be more, the profit at the night might be more. So therefore we say that this contract, it is invalid.
أو أخذ سيارة إنسان وأقول خذ قيمة هذه السيارة. قال أنا غير راضي. نقول له رضيت أو لا. لابد أن أخذ منك هذه السيارة. خذ هذا المال وانتهى الأمر. هذا ظلم. نعم. لابد من رضا البائع وكذلك المشتري على ما سيأتي بإذن الله. لكن هذا مثال على الظلم. نعم.
And also as another example, if we take a person's car, we take the car and we say, here's the money, we're buying your car. And he says, I'm not happy or I'm not pleased with selling my car. And you say to him, no, here's the money, you have to buy the car, even if it's a full value. We say that this is now oppression because, and we're going to discuss this, one of the conditions is that both the buyer and the seller must both be pleased and accept the contract or the transaction.
نعم. الغرر والجهالة مثاله يعني أنا أقول لهذا الأخ يقول عندي جهاز محمول جوال تشتريه مني £50. طب يقول ما هي مواصفات هذا الجهاز أو أرى هذا الجهاز ولا أي نوع هو هل هو آيفون أو سامسونج أو نوكيا أقول له لا أنت تدفع لي 50 وأنا أعطيك هذا قد لا يساوي باوند واحد وقد يساوي أكثر. نعم.
And then the second condition we mentioned is الغرر أو جهالة. And غرر and جهالة means that there's an aspect of ambiguity or there's an aspect of ignorance regarding either the price or that which is being sold. So for example, if a person has a mobile in his pocket and he says that give me £50 and I'll sell you this mobile in my pocket. And you ask him, okay, what is the mobile in your pocket? What type is it? What's the model? What does it have? What's the description? And he says, no, you give me £50 and I will give you whatever the mobile is in my pocket. Again, this transaction, this contract is not correct because it contains a level of ambiguity and something which is not known. The mobile might be worth £1 or it might be worth £100.
نعم. الثالث ألا يكون في العقد ربا وسيأتي معنا إن شاء الله تعالى أن الربا ينقسم إلى قسمين. نعم.
And then the third condition is that this transaction must not contain any riba, any form of interest. And we will discuss in a short while that riba is of two types.
نعم. يذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى أن من شروط البيع الآن أجملنا والآن نريد أن نذكر التفصيل. نعم.
So we've mentioned the three conditions that a transaction must have or the three things that must be avoided in a contract for it to be correct. This is generally speaking, this is as an overview. Now we want to mention this in detail.
فمن شروط البيع الرضا.
So in terms of one of the conditions of buying and selling is a rida, that both the parties have to be pleased and happy and they have to accept it.
فإن لم يرضى البائع أو المشتري بالبيع فالبيع باطل. نعم.
So if the buyer or the seller is not pleased with or does not accept the contract or the transaction, then we say that that transaction, it is invalid.
يقول الآن أمثلة على الجهالة والغرر في البيع. نعم.
And also examples of ambiguity or matters of ignorance in a transaction of buying and selling.
لديه حيوان مثلا يعني جمل.
A person, for example, he owns an animal, a camel.
أو نوع من الطير صقر مثلا.
Or a person owns an eagle or a bird.
وقال تشتري مني هذا الجمل أو هذا الصقر.
And you say to a person, will you buy from me this camel or this eagle?
تقول له نعم. لكن أين الجمل أو أين هذا الصقر؟ يقول هذا قد شرد. شارد يسميه الشارد أو الهارب. هرب منه. نعم. فهل يصح البيع هنا؟ لا يصح البيع. نعم.
And when you say to him, okay, where is this eagle or where is the camel? He says, oh, the eagle has escaped, or the camel has also escaped and is fled away. So here, is the transaction correct? No.
أو يقول أبيعك إحدى السيارتين. إذا كان لديه مثلا سيارات BMW موديل واحد مواصفات واحدة وهذا المعرض وقال أي سيارة من هذه السيارات ب100,000 مثلا هل يصح هذا البيع؟ يصح ولا إشكال لأن هذه متساوية في القيمة لكن يقول أنا أبيع لك إما السيارة بإم أو السيارة البيجو فهذه لها قيمة مرتفعة وهذه لها قيمة متوسطة مثلا مفهوم؟ فقد يدفع قيمة ويأخذ التي لها قيمة عالية أو يأخذ التي لها قيمة متوسطة لابد أن يحدد المبيع. نعم.
If a person says, now we're talking about ambiguity in a transaction. If a person says, I'm going to sell you one of my cars, and he has a number of cars. If it's, for example, a showroom, and in the showroom, he has only BMWs, and every one of his BMW is exactly the same model, the same type, with the same specifications. In this situation, if he says, you can have any one of these cars for 100,000, for example, this transaction is correct. Why? Because the price is known, 100,000, and also the buyer knows the exact model and specifications and type of car, because all the cars are the same and they're the same price. So here the transaction would be correct. However, in his showroom he has, for example, a BMW and a Peugeot and other models. And then he says, "You can have. I'm going to sell you one of these cars for 100,000. Now we would say that this transaction isn't correct because there is a level of ambiguity. The BMW is worth more, the Persian might be worth less.
نعم. أو ما نراه الآن في بعض المحلات كل شيء بعشرة.
نعم.
يعني حتى هنا موجود. أن تدخل كل شيء بعشرة باوند. هل يصح هذا البيع ولا يصح؟ يصح. لأن السلع هذه كلها متساوية تقريبا في القيمة ثم قبل أن يشتري ينظر في هذه السلعة ويأخذها بيده نعم يصح هذا البيع
Now we have shops like we have here and in different places For example, anything in this shop is worth a pound or everything in this shop is worth 10 pounds Is it now correct for a person to buy in this shop where everything is worth 10 pounds? We say yes, it is correct for two reasons Number one that in most cases, almost all of the things in there are actually worth around about 10 pounds. And secondly, because before you buy anything, you can have a look at it, you know exactly its specifications, its model, its type, and you also know the price. So therefore, this transaction would be correct.
أو يغمض عيني ويقول تدخل الآن إلى هذا معرض السيارات. فيه سيارات مختلفة الأنواع والأسعار. وأي سيارة تضع يديك عليها هي لك بألف أو 100,000 مثلا نعم هذا لا يجوز نعم
another scenario is if you go to a showroom with different cars of different prices and the seller says to you close your eyes come inside and whichever hand you put your car on you can have that car for £1,000 for example whilst closing your eyes we say that this transaction is not correct because it contains ambiguity غرر أو جهالة
نعم أو يقول خذ هذه الحصى وارمي بها المكان الذي تسقط فيه هذه الحصى من الأرض هو لك بكذا قد تكون تقع هذه الحصى في مكان بعيد أو في مكان قريب نعم هذا لا يصح
And also, as another scenario, if a person says that take this stone and throw it as far as you can, and wherever the stone lands, then from here up until that limit or that place, you can have for a certain price. Again, this is a transaction which wouldn't be accepted. Why? Because the stone, it might land far away and you have more land, or it might land near and you have less land. So there is a level of ambiguity, a level of jahala and gharar.
نعم. أو يبيع مثلا ما في بطن الدابة سواء كانت بقرة أو شاء أو ما إلى ذلك. لا يصح بيع الحمل لأنه لا ندري هل هذا ذكر أم أنثى، ينزل حي أو ميت أو أعرج أو أعور أو ما إلى ذلك. لكن يصح يبيع البقرة وهي حامل، يثبت تبعا ما لا يثبت استقلالا. نعم.
Another example of gharar and jahala, ambiguity in a transaction is if a person says that I'm going to sell to you that which is in the womb of, for example, the camel or the cow, the young she camel or the camel which is in the womb of the camel. We say that this transaction is not permitted because of the ambiguity. We don't know, is the camel which is in the womb of the camel, is it male, female? Is it going to be born alive? Is it going to come out dead? Is it going to be ill or weak? Or is it going to be strong? So in that scenario, we say that this transaction is not correct because of gharar and jahala. However, at the same time, a person can sell a she-camel which is pregnant. So now a person is selling the actual camel itself, including what is in the camel.
طيب. إذن بعد هذا نذكر الآن الأمر الثالث وهو الربا. نعم.
And now after this, the second condition that we're going to mention is riba, interest.
الربا ينقسم إلى قسمين.
Riba, interest, it is divided into two categories.
ربا الفضل وربا النسيئة. ربا الفضل يعني ربا الزيادة، وربا النسيئة أي ربا التأخير. نعم.
So there are two types of interest, what they call riba al-fadl and riba al-nasi'ah. Riba al-fadl, interest, is when extra money or an addition is given to you. And riba al-nasi'ah is when there is a delay in something.
نعم. Riba al-fadl al-ziyada. يعني مثاله الآن يبيع طن من التمر القديم بنصف طن من التمر الجديد، هذا ربا الفضل، لأن هذا يزيد عن هذا، فهذا لا يجوز. نعم.
So, as an example of ربا الفضل, where there's an addition, a person, he exchanges a ton of old dates for half a ton of new dates. In this situation, we would say that this is ربا الفضل because there is an increase or an addition in that which you're exchanging. And therefore it's not permissible.
نعم. أو يقول له خذ مني طن من التمر اليوم وترجع لي بعد 10 أيام طن من التمر، هل يصح؟ لا يصح، لأن هذا ربا النسيئة التأخير. نعم.
And also as an example of ربا النسيئة is if a person says to you, look, take a ton of dates now and 10 days later or a while later give me another ton of dates. Here we say that this is interest in this category.
نعم. الأموال التي تجري فيها الربا. نعم.
So riba, it's applicable to certain types of wealth. What are those types of wealth upon which riba or the ruling of riba is applicable?
الأول الذهب والفضة وما يقوم مقام الذهب والفضة من العملة الورقية.
So the first type of wealth in which riba interest is applicable and takes the ruling of something being riba is gold or silver or anything which comes now in the position of gold and silver, like for example currency and banknotes and coins.
نعم. هل يصح بيع الذهب بالذهب؟ نعم.
Is it permissible for a person to exchange or to buy gold with gold?
أو فضة بفضة؟
Or is it permissible for a person to buy silver with silver?
أو باوند بباوند؟
Or buy a pound with a pound?
أو دولار بدولار؟
or you know the same currencies, selling and buying dollars.
يصح بشرطين.
It is correct, but with two conditions.
التقابض في مجلس العقد والتماثل أن يبيع طن من الذهب بطن من الذهب وأن يتقابض في مجلس العقد.
So there are two conditions. The first condition is that the exchange and the possession of both of the stocks that you're exchanging and buying and selling that has to be done within the same sitting or within the same instance of exchange or contract. And then the second condition is الثاني الشرط الثاني.
الشرط الثاني الشرط الأول التقابض والشرط الثاني التماثل طن بطن.
And also then the second condition is that there it has to be the same amount, i.e. a ton of gold for a ton of gold, or X amount of dollars for X amount.
يقول مثلا يأتينا إنسان الآن ولديه ذهب قديم ويحتاج إلى ذهب جديد. نعم.
As an example, a person comes and he's got some old gold with him. It's old. And he wants to exchange this for gold which is new.
فأتي إلى هذا الذي يبيع الذهب ويقول خذ مني هذا الذهب القديم وأريد مكان هذا الذهب ذهب جديد. نعم. هل يصح هذا البيع أو لا يصح؟
And he comes to the person who is selling gold and he says to him, take this gold from me which is old and give me in its place or exchange it with gold which is new.
يصح بشرطين.
It is correct and permissible but with two conditions.
أن يكون الذهب القديم مثلا طن والذهب الجديد طن. هذا تحقق الشرط الأول التماثل. نعم.
That both the amounts of the gold have to be the same. So it has to be a ton of gold for a ton of gold.
الشرط الثاني أن يتقابض الآن يعطيه القديم وهذا يعطيه الجديد في وقت واحد. نعم.
And also the second condition is that both of these stocks have to be possessed at the same time, i.e. in the same sitting or in the same contract, he gives him the old gold and this one takes the new gold in the same instance.
في الغالب أن صاحب هذا المحل لا يرضى. يقول كيف أعطيك ذهب جديد وتعطيني ذهب قديم. نعم.
In most cases, the person who owns the shop, he's not going to be happy. He's not going to be pleased with this. He's going to say, how am I giving you new gold? I'm taking from you old gold.
فماذا يصنع هذا الآن الذي لديه ذهب قديم؟
So the person who has this old gold, what should he do?
يذهب ويبيع هذا الذهب القديم ويحصل مثلا على مال ثم يأتي ويشتري به ذهب جديد. نعم.
He should go and sell this gold that he has in his possession, take the money, and then with that money go and buy the equivalent gold which is new.
هل يصح أن يبيع هذا الذهب القديم على هذا صاحب الدكان الذي يأخذ منه الذهب الجديد؟
Is it permitted for this person to sell his gold to that very person who is going to exchange the new gold with? So he sells the gold and takes money off him.
لأن أحيانا صاحب هذا الدكان يقول أنا أشتري منك هذا القديم بمئة مثلا وأعطيك الجديد بمئة وعشرين. تأخذ منك القديم وأعطيك الجديد وتعطيني عشرين. نعم.
Because sometimes the person who owns the shop, he might say to him that I'll buy this gold off you, let's say for £100, and then I'll buy this gold off you for £100, and then I will sell the new gold to you, but you have to give me £20 extra. Or a person says that we can exchange this gold, but you give me £20 extra.
هذا لا يصح البيع.
So here, this is not permissible.
لأن الحقيقة البيع هذا أنه أخذ طن بطن وعشرين فلم يتحقق التماثل. نعم.
Because the reality of this transaction is that he's taken a ton of gold and he's given a ton of gold, but he's given £20 extra. He's taken £20 extra. So now the condition of the amounts being equal and the same is not fulfilled.
أو قال أخذ منك هذا الذهب القديم طن وأعطيك مكان هذا الذهب القديم طن لكن بعد سنة. نعم.
Or if a person says that I'll take this old gold off you now, a ton of old gold right now, but I'm going to give you the new gold, a ton of new gold after a year.
هنا تحقق الشرط الأول وهو التماثل طن بطن لكن لم يتحقق الشرط الثاني التقابض في مجلس العقد فهو ربا نسيئة. التأخير.
So this transaction is not correct because it is riba, the second type of riba. Why? Although the amount is the same, although it's a ton for a ton, however, both these stocks, the new gold and the old gold, haven't been exchanged and possessed in the same sitting.
الآن يكون معك ورقة واحدة فئة 50 باوند موجودة. أعلى فئة عندكم.
50
باوند. نعم. فلديه ورقة واحدة فئة 50 باوند. نعم.
In our currency, we have a bank note which is worth 50 pounds.
فيأخذ هذه الفئة ويأتي بها إلى هذا صاحب الدكان.
So he takes this 50 pound note and he comes to the shopkeeper.
ويقول أريد أن تصرف لي هذه الخمسين. نعم.
And he says to him, I want you to change this 50 pounds for me.
نعم. فهذا يعطيها الآن 50 ب50. هل يصح؟
So he now gives him 50 pounds back and he gives him the 50 pounds. Is this correct?
هذا بيع باوند بباوند. مثل ما بعنا الذهب بالذهب والفضة بالفضة. هذا كذلك. نعم.
So this is now selling a pound for a pound or exchanging pounds for pounds just like we would exchange gold for gold and silver for silver.
أنا أعرف أن بعضكم يقول هذا صرف. الصرف بيع.
I know some of you might say that this is changing money. This is giving change. But in reality, in fiqh, this is considered as buying and selling, i.e. giving something in exchange for something else.
ويجري فيه الربا.
And therefore, even in this, riba can occur.
لو قال له أعطيك 40 باوند وأنت تعطيني 50 باوند. هل يصح؟
If a person was to say, I'll give you 40 pounds, but you give me 50 pounds back. Would this be correct?
أو أخذ باوند واحد مقابل الصرف مثلا.
Or a person says that I'm going to take off you 1 pound extra for changing or exchanging this money.
لا يصح.
This is not permissible.
أو قال له خذ الآن 20 باوند وبعد ساعة إن شاء الله أعطيك 30 باوند. هل يصح؟ لا يصح. لأنه لابد من التقابض. التماثل والتقابض لأنه يبيع باوند بباوند. نعم.
Or a person says that give me 20 pounds now and come back in an hour's time and I'll give you 30 pounds for example. Is this correct? No. Because again as we mentioned there has to be تقابض. The possession of both of the goods and the exchange of both of the goods have to be done in the same instance or the same contact or the same sitting.
لكن يشتري مثلا الآن أريد دولار ومعه هو اشترليني الآن. فهل يصح؟ هل لابد من التماثل؟ لا، لا يشترط التماثل، لكن يشترط التقابض. نعم.
But let's say if these two types are different. For example, a person wants to exchange or buy and sell, if we're talking the language of fiqh, if a person wants to exchange dollar for pound, do we have to say now the same two conditions that we said with pound and pound and gold, meaning that you have to exactly have, you have to have exactly the same amount and you have to possess it at the same time? No. So here the condition is that you have to possess it at the same time. The exchange of both of those things has to take place at the same time. However, because the currency is different, we don't say that the amount has to be equal.
نعم. يعطيه مثلا 100 باوند والآخر يعطيه 80 دولار مثلا. يصح هذا؟ يصح بشرط التقابض. نعم.
As an example, you give the person 100 pounds and he gives you back $80. Is this correct? Yes, this is correct, but with the intention that the possession and the exchange has to take place in that instance.
طن من الذهب بعشرين طن من الفضة. يصح؟ يصح بشرط التقابض.
Is it permitted for a person to sell a ton of gold for 20 tons of silver, for example? Yes, it is correct and accepted as long as the condition of the exchange and the possession takes place in that sitting.
إذن الذهب بالذهب، بيع الذهب بالذهب، والفضة بالفضة، والباوند بالباوند، واليورو باليورو، والدولار بالدولار، لابد فيه من التقابض والتماثل. نعم.
And therefore, selling or exchanging gold with gold, silver with silver, pound with pound, euro with euro, dollar with dollar, any currency with the same currency, then it can be done but fulfilling two conditions. The first condition is التقابض, that there has to be a possession of exchange in that sitting, and then the second condition is that they have to be similar amounts.
ذهب بفضة، ذهب بباوند، يورو بباوند، هذا يشترط فيه التقابض. نعم.
And as for exchanging these things, but they are different, i.e. exchanging or buying gold for silver, or silver for pound, or pound for a euro, or a euro for a dollar, then they don't have to be the same amount, but the condition is that the possession has to take place and the exchange has to take place in that instance.
نعم. ننتقل إلى النوع الثاني. نعم.
من؟
أخذنا الآن النوع الأول الثمنية الذهب والفضة وما يقوم مقام الذهب والفضة. هذا انتهينا من هذا القسم الأول.
So talking about the types of wealth or the types of products in which riba, the ruling of riba becomes applicable, the first type we said was anything which has this type of value, gold or silver, any type of currency. The second type is
نعم الثاني القمح والشعير والتمر والزبيب والرز وهذا وهذه الأشياء. نعم
القط
أمشي بس.
We have wheat and barley, dates and rice and things similar to this.
نعم تمر بتمر.
So in terms of selling or exchanging dates for dates,
هذا لابد فيه من التقابض والتماثل.
Then the same two conditions have to be fulfilled. Similar amounts and exchange of possession.
تمر بشعير.
Selling dates or exchanging dates with barley.
يشترط فيه التقابض ولا يشترط فيه التماثل.
Then only one condition is stipulated, and that is the condition of the exchange of possession, but not that they have to be the same amount.
طعام. هذه الأشياء طعام.
So these things now, this category comes under food.
ويعني هي في الحقيقة قوت يعني ما أعرف وتدخر. نعم.
So this is the umbrella of food, however specifically staple food, i.e. those types of food that can be stored for a long time.
نعم. بعد هذا القسم الثالث ما يصلح به الطعام الملح والبهارات.
And then the third type of wealth or product in which riba applies is things like salt and spices.
نعم. هذه الأصناف التي يجري فيها الربا. الأول العلة فيه أن النقد والثمنية. والثاني العلة فيه أنه مطعوم وقوت ويدخر. والثالث ما يصلح به الطعام الملح والبهارات. نعم.
So these are the three categories, broadly speaking, in which riba, the ruling of riba applies. The first is, we mentioned gold, silver, and wealth. So the reason behind this, the illa, or the reason why riba applies is because it has a value or a currency behind it. And then the second type is those things which are taken as staple foods, and those things which can be stored away for a while. So again, this is the illa, this is the reason for which riba applies upon this. And then the second or the third type is those things by which there is taste or there is food, salt and spices.
نعم. الآن تأتي إلى البقالة إلى الدكان وتشتري منه رز سكر شعير قمح تمر وتقول له أعطيك المال في آخر الشهر عندما أستلم الراتب. نعم.
Let's say now if you come to a shop and you buy from him rice, wheat, barley, sugar, salt, and you say, look, I'll give you the money at the end of the month when I get my wage.
نعم. هو اشترى الآن قوت بباوند بعملة ورقية. يصح يصح ولا إشكال. لكن قال آخذ منك تمر اليوم وأعطيك مكانه تمر في آخر الشهر فهذا لا يصح لأنه لابد في بيع التمر بالتمر من التقابض والتماثل. نعم.
So if a person says like this scenario, that I'm going to buy from you, I'm going to take from you now rice and wheat and barley and sugar and salt and dates, but I'm going to give you the money for it at the end of the month when I get my wage, then there's no problem with this. This is correct. Why? Because these are two totally different things. One of the things, the illa is value and currency, either money that he's giving. And the other thing is the illa or the reason behind it is that it's the food which can be stored away. So because they're two different reasons and two different types of products, then it's correct. You know, you don't have to have the two conditions of similar amounts and an exchange of possession at that instance. If, however, a person was to say that you're buying and selling the things with the same reason behind it, so you say, I want dates from you now, and I'll give you the dates in exchange after a month, for example. Here we say no, the both of these conditions have to be fulfilled.
نعم. ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ألا يقع العقد على ما هو محرم. نعم. إما على ما هو محرم. ألا يقع العقد على محرم. نعم.
And also from the conditions or from the ways in which a transaction can be haram in itself is that the transaction or the exchange is regarding something which is haram. One of the products is haram in itself.
أو يا المحرم إما محرم لعينه كبيع الخمر.
So either the product is haram because the product itself is haram, like buying and selling alcohol, for example.
وهذا يعني الخمر مثال لكل ما يفسد العقل. نعم. المخدرات المسكرات بأنواعها هل يصح أن تباع؟ لا. نعم.
And when we say alcohol, what we mean by this is everything which corrupts a person's intellect. So whether it's drugs or intoxicants, any type of intoxicant which corrupts a person's intellect and thinking.
الثاني الميتة. والميتة مثال على كل ما يفسد الأبدان. نعم. يفسد البدن. الميتة السم وما إلى ذلك. نعم.
And also the second type of thing which is haram to trade because itself the product is haram is a mayta, a dead carcass. But we don't just mean the dead carcass in itself, we mean a dead carcass and everything or anything which would corrupt and destroy a person's body. So for example, poison.
الثالث الأصنام وهذا مثال لكل ما يفسد الأديان أي الدين الإسلامي. نعم.
And then the third type in which the product itself is haram to buy and sell are idols. And this is a general category of anything which would spoil or corrupt a person's religion, i.e. a person's Islam.
كتب السحر.
So for example, under this category would be books containing magic.
كتب الضلال.
Books of misguidance.
الأشرطة مثلا التي فيها تعليم السحر أو فيها الشرك الأكبر. نعم.
Those cassettes or videos which contain instructions for magic and things like this.
نعم. ولا يصح أن يبيع على بيع أخيه أو يشتري على شراء أخيه. هذا يأتي بالمثال. نعم.
And it's not permissible for a person to come in and undercut his brother. بيع على بيع أخيه. And we're going to come to examples of this is نأتي بالمثال.
المثال.
Give an example.
الآن. اشترى هذا الأخ مني هذا الجهاز بمئة باوند.
As an example, I have now come and I've bought this mobile of him for 100 pounds.
أنا الآن بعت الجهاز بمئة باوند. نعم.
So he has now sold this mobile to me for 100 pounds.
فجاء هذا الأخ.
Now another brother comes.
وقال لهذا المشتري.
And he says to me, the one who is buying.
قال أنا أبيع لك مثل هذا الجوال بتسعين باوند.
He says that I will sell you exactly the same type of phone for only 90 pounds.
هذا ماذا صنع الآن؟ باع على بيعي. نعم.
So now what has he done? He has made a transaction over his transaction.
نعم. هذا حرام.
So this is not permissible.
وهذا يقع كثير.
And this happens a lot.
اعتبر بعض الناس يقول يا أخي كيف تشتري هذا بمئة؟ أنا أعطيك أحسن منه أو كذا أو مثله بتسعين. حرام هذا. نعم.
So this happens a lot. A person when he comes to me says, you know, how have you bought this for this price? I will give you exactly the same thing for much cheaper and it's better. This now is haram and it's not permissible.
أو الشراء على شرائه.
And also the opposite, which is buying a transaction of buying over a transaction of buying instead of selling.
بعت لهذا الأخ. هذا الجهاز بمئة باوند.
So if he has now sold this to me for 100 pounds.
فجاءني هذا وقال أنا أشتري منك هذا الجهاز بمئة وعشرة.
And another person comes to him, the buyer, and he says, I'll buy this phone from you, the one that you sold to me for 110 pounds.
لماذا تبيع هذا الجهاز بمئة؟ أنا أشتريها منك بأكثر من هذا. هذا الشراء على شرائي. نعم.
Why are you selling this to him for 100 pounds when I'll come and buy this off you for 110 pounds? This is now the opposite of this, which is شراء على شراء أخي.
في الأول أضر بالبائع وفي الثاني أضر بالمشتري.
So in the first instance, the harm is upon the one who is buying, and in the second instance, the harm is upon the one who is selling.
كذلك ما يحصل الآن في المزادات المزاد يعني yeah. الآن
Options.
الآن يكون لدينا سلعة فيتفق الناس على وقت يأتون وكل واحد يزيد في ثمن هذه السلعة هذا يجوز ولا إشكال فيه نعم
Now we have something called بيع المزايدة and these are auctions whereby you have one particular product and the people they congregate in one specific time and they outbid each other This is permitted and there's nothing wrong with it.
نعم لكن الإشكال في أنه يأتي أحيانا بعض الناس يريد فقط الإضرار إما بالبائع أو بالمشتري أو بهما جميعا نعم يعني يزيد في السلعة في ثمن السلعة ولا يريد الشراء نعم
The problem here is when a person comes and he just comes for the he only bids in order to harm the buyer or the seller or both of them So he bids and he outbids not because he wants to buy it, because he wants to increase the price and therefore harm the person who is buying, for example.
نعم وكذلك لا يجوز البيع على إنسان تعلم منه أنه يستخدم هذا المبيع في معصية. نعم.
And also, it is not permitted for you to sell a product to a person who you know and you're certain that this person is going to use this product. For something which involves sinning and disobedience to Allah.
ما حكم بيع العنب؟
What is the ruling of selling grapes?
جائز.
It's permitted.
لكن جاك إنسان وتعرف أن لديه مصنع للخمور عياذا بالله وقال أريد منك هذا العنب حتى أصنع خمر. أنت تبيع عنب الآن لا تبيع خمر. هل يصح هذا البيع؟
So you're selling grapes. There's nothing wrong with selling grapes. However, a person comes to you and he wants to buy these grapes of you. And you know that this person, he has a brewery where he brews alcohol. And you know that these grapes that he's buying, he's going to go and use them in alcohol. Even though you're only selling grapes and you're not selling alcohol, but here, is it correct?
لا يجوز. لأن هذا فيه تعاون على الإثم والعدوان. نسأل الله العافية والسلام.
So in this instance, this transaction, this selling of grapes to this person is not permitted because in it is... cooperating upon sinning and evil.
بيع البيض. ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بيع البيض.
The author, may Allah mercy upon him, he mentions selling eggs.
ما حكم بيع البيض؟
What is the ruling of selling eggs?
جائز. لكن.
It's permitted.
يبيع البيض على من يقامر به. يعني يتحدى بعض الناس الآن. هذا يدفع ألف وهذا يدفع ألف وهذا يدفع ألف ويأتوا ببيضة. يقول الذي يكسر البيضة بهذه الصورة. يأخذ 3000
بالضبط
مفهوم؟ أي نعم هو مثل على هذا المؤلف مثل على هذا على بيع البيض نعم
So the author he gives an example that selling eggs the default the base ruling that it is correct to sell eggs however there's a type of gambling or qimar whereby they say that the person who gets his egg and the person who can break it with his fingers like this then he gets for example, £1,000. This one will get £1,000. This one will give £2,000. This one will get £3,000, as an example. And then the winner, he takes £3,000. Each one says that whoever can break it, we will give £1,000 each. Here it becomes impermissible.
بيع السلاح في الفتنة وقت الفتنة. أنت تعرف الآن مثلاً في بعض الدول. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يمن. علينا برجوع هذه الدول والأمن والإيمان فيها يا رب فهذه الدول الآن فيها فتنة فيأتي بعض الناس ويريد شراء أسلحة لماذا؟ لقتل مسلم ويريد أشتري منك السلاح تبيع السلاح فأنت شريك له في الإثم نعم
In terms of buying and selling weapons nowadays you know how in certain countries there's war and there are calamities and problems So this person comes to you and he wants to buy this weapon of you because you know that he's going to go and use this weapon in order to go kill a Muslim. In this instance, this transaction is not correct.
أو تبيع السلاح على قطاع الطرق.
Or for you to sell weapons to bandits and highway robbers.
أو على اللصوص.
Or thieves and robbers.
نعم. كذلك نهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن تلقي الجلب. الآن هناك أناس يعملون في القرى في الزراعة وهو لا يعرف الأسعار التي في المدينة، فيأتي يريد يبيع مثلا ما لديه من مثلا بطاطس أو طماطم مثلا، فعندما يريد الدخول إلى السوق يستقبل هذا على أطراف المدينة ويقول أنا أشتري منك هذه السلعة بكذا. نهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن هذا. نعم، لأنه هذا الآن الذي يسكن في القرية لا يعرف الأسعار في الغالب. نعم.
Then there's another scenario of buying and selling or transaction, and it's called تلقي الجلب. يسمى تلقي الركبان كذلك.
المهم تلقي الرجل الذي ليس لا يعرف الأسعار التي في السوق، يتلقى قبل أن يدخل للسوق. نعم.
So it's called in fiqh, this is called تلقي الجلب. And this is when you have a person, let's say he's a Bedouin from the desert or a farm or a village area, and a person in the city is selling something. So when he hears of this person coming towards the city in order to buy something, he'll go out from the Medina, go out to the village, go out from the city, go out to the village, or go out to the road and say to him, look, I'm going to sell you this product for this price. This isn't permissible. Why? Because the person who's a farmer or in the desert or is in a village somewhere, he doesn't know the normal price of that product. And this person might go and sell him twice the value of what the actual value is. And therefore, doing that is not permissible.
نعم. لكن إن حصل بينهما بيع.
However, if a transaction occurs between them,
فهذا الذي لا يعرف سعر المدينة، هذا المزارع وكذا، هو بالخيار بعد أن يدخل إلى المدينة ويعرف الأسعار، إما أن يجعل هذا البيع صحيح أو يقوم بنقض هذا البيع ويقول أنا لا أرضى بهذا البيع. نعم.
If this transaction does take place, then the one who bought the product, the farmer or the Bedouin in the desert, then he has a choice. Once he goes into the city and finds out the price, if he's happy with the price that he's been sold at, then he can keep the product and the transaction is correct. If, however, he isn't happy with the price, then it's entirely his choice to say, I'm not happy with this transaction and the contract is annulled Islamically, and he can return the product and the price.
أو التحايل على الربا بالبيع، يعني حيلة، يصنع حيلة حتى يجعل الربا حلال. نعم.
And also another type of transaction which is impermissible is when people, due to how they word contracts or due to a level of trickery and deviousness, they, you know, in reality it's riba, in reality it's interest, but they do it in a particular way whereby people think that it's not riba.
مثال الآن.
As an example.
رجل يريد من آخر قرض، يقول أريد منك 10,000 باوند، قرض حسن، أرجع لك بعد سنة. نعم.
A person, he wants to get some money off a person as a loan. So a person, he goes to another person, he says, I need £10,000 off you. It's a normal loan. And this £10,000, I will return to you after a year.
قال لا، أعطيك عشرة بشرط أن ترجع لي هذا المال بزيادة 2000. نعم.
This person who is giving the money, he says, no. I'll give you £10,000. However, after a year, I want £12,000 off you. I want £10,000 and £2,000 more.
يقول هذا ربا محرم، لا يجوز.
So this person says that this is riba, this is interest, and it's not permitted and it's haram.
يقول طيب اسمع.
So he says, okay, listen to me.
تشتري مني هذه السيارة.
Buy from me this car.
ب10,000.
For £10,000.
يقول أنا لا أريد السيارة. يقول أنت تشتري مني السيارة الآن ب10,000.
He says that, look, I don't want this car, and he says just buy this car for me now for £10,000.
قال نعم أشتري منك السيارة.
He says okay, I'll buy the car for you.
فيبيع السيارة.
So he sells him the car.
ويكتب عليه أن اشترى منه السيارة ب10,000.
And then he writes that this car has been sold to him for 10,000 pounds.
ثم بعد هذا قال تبيع عن السيارة.
And then straight away goes back to him and says, will you sell the car back to me now?
قال نعم.
He says yes.
قال بكم؟
He says by how much?
بثمانية آلاف.
He says by only 8,000 pounds.
يعني في الحقيقة كأنه أعطاه 8,000 وأرجعها له 10,000. نعم. هذا ربا.
So in reality, it's as if the person he has given him 8,000 pounds, but taken back 10,000 pounds from him. So in reality, this is a riba.
نعم. كذلك الآن إنسان لديه يعني تمر ولا يعرف مقدار هذا التمر كم يساوي، والآخر كذلك لديه تمر. قال تعطيني هذا التمر بهذا التمر. نحن لا نعلم مقدار هذا بهذا، هل يصح هذا البيع؟ لا يصح، لأنه هذا البيع يعني بيع التمر بالتمر لابد فيه من التماثل، ونحن الآن لم يتحقق عندنا شرط التماثل، لابد من النكيل الأول ونكيل الثاني استويا وتقابض في مجلس العقد، فالبيع صحيح وإلا فهو باطل. نعم.
Another example of a transaction which is impermissible is if a person has a certain amount of dates and he wants to sell them for another amount of dates. However, the buyer doesn't know how many kilos he has, and neither does the seller know how many kilos he has. And they say that let's just exchange or buy and sell these dates, exchange these dates for these dates. Is this transaction correct? We said no. Why? Because one of the conditions is at-tamathul, that both of the amounts have to be known and be equal. So therefore, we have to measure these dates, and we have to measure them dates, and if the amount is similar, then they can exchange them.
Now. ذهب مجموعة إلى الحج.
A group of people they went to perform Hajj.
واحتاج واحد منهم إلى مال.
And one of them he needed some wealth, some money.
فجاء إلى الأخ وقال أريد منك 1,000 ريال سعودي.
So one of them approached another one of the brothers and he said, I need of you 1,000 Saudi riyals.
نعم. فأعطاه 1,000 ريال قرض حسن.
So he gives him as a good loan, 1,000 riyal Saudi.
ثم عندما رجعوا إلى بلادهم، مثلا رجعوا إلى المغرب العربي. نعم.
And then once they return back to their countries, let's say they return back to one of the northern African countries.
أو رجعوا إلى هنا إلى بريطانيا.
Or they come back to Britain, for example.
وقال أنا أريد أعطيك الآن هذا 1,000 ريال سعودي القرض. أرجع لك القرض. نعم.
And he now says, I want to repay this debt which is upon me of 1,000 Saudi riyals.
لكن ليس عندي الآن نقود سعودية، عملة ورقية سعودية. لدي باوند.
But right now I don't have Saudi riyals with me anymore. I only have pounds.
فهل يصح أن يعطيه باوند مقابل الريال السعودي؟
Is it permitted for him to give him the pounds, repay the debt or the loan in terms of pounds instead of the Saudi riyals?
لأنه هو الآن هذا ليس لديه ريال سعودي، وكذلك هذا الذي له الدين لا يريد الآن ريال سعودي هنا، يريد باوند، فماذا يفعل؟ نعم.
So that person who has the debt on top of him, the loan on top of him, he doesn't have Saudi riyals, he only has English money, pounds. And also the person who gave the debt and gave the loan, he doesn't need pound, he doesn't need riyals either, he wants pounds. So therefore what should they do?
يصح إعطاء هذا بغير العملة بشرطين.
It's correct for that person to repay him in another currency but with two conditions.
الشرط الأول أن يعطيه بسعر الصرف اليوم، يعني يذهب إلى مكان الصرف ويقول مثلا 1,000 ريال سعودي تساوي 200 باوند. نعم. هذا الشرط الأول أن يعطيه بسعر الصرف اليوم. نعم.
The first condition is that he has to repay him the amount in pounds according to the value of the currency exchange today. So he goes to the currency exchange and he finds out what is the value of the real and the pound right now and not what it was back then, and then he gives him that amount. So if 1,000 riyals today right now is worth 200 pounds, he gives him back 200 pounds.
الشرط الثاني.
And the second condition is
ألا يبقى عليه شيء، يعني لابد أن يعطيه 200 كاملة. لو قال أعطيك 100 اليوم و100 بعد ساعة أو بعد سنة لا يصح، حرام. نعم.
And then the other condition is that he has to repay the debt or the loan, all of it in totality. So you can't say, for example, it's worth £200, I'll give you £100 now, and then in a couple of hours' time or in a year's time, I'll give you the other 100. In that case, it's not permissible. So he has to fully pay his debt, give him the full £200 right now.
نعم. ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى نوع آخر من أنواع البيع. نعم.
And then after this, the author, he mentioned another type of transactions.
بيع الأصول والثمار. يعني الآن يشتري منه أشجار. يشتري منه بستان وبما فيه من الأشجار. نعم.
This is called بيع الأصول بالفروض. As an example.
بيع الأصول. الله سبحانه وتعالى قال أصلها ثابت. هذه الأشجار الآن. هذه أصول وفرعها في السماء أو الثمار هذه تتفرع من الأصل فبيع الأصول يعني الأشجار نعم.
So when we say بيع الأصول بالفروع, of course in the Arabic language.
ما في بالفروع يا رجل.
كيف قلتم؟
من جديد.
أنا مثل إيش بالفروع؟
لا لا لا. أترك. الآن من جديد. يريد أن يبيع بستان بما فيه من أشجار. نعم هكذا.
A person, he wants to sell a garden with the trees.
هل يصح هذا البيع?
Is it allowed for him to sell the garden with the trees and everything which is in the garden?
يصح لا إشكال.
It's permitted and there's no problem.
لكن لابد أن تتنبه إلى مسألة.
But you have to pay attention to a particular point.
أن هذا البستان أو هذه الأرض إذا كان فيها نخل مثلا نعم.
That if this garden or if this farm or land, if it has date trees, for example, date palms.
النخل يلقح. لابد أن يلقح النخل حتى تخرج الثمرة. فالبائع الآن, البائع صاحب البستان الأول, إذا لقح هذا النخل, ثم بعد هذا جئت أنت واشتريت منه البستان بما فيه من النخل. مفهوم؟ نعم.
تلقيح غير معروف. شد تلقيح ها فترة that's in children and
المهم
ما
أنا أقول لك
غير موجود أصلا
باع البستان بما فيه من أشجار من النخيل نعم
so a person he sells a garden or an orchard of dates an orchard of date palms
وكان قد يعني تدخل وعمل يعني في هذا النخل لإصلاح الثمرة حتى لا تفسد. نعم.
أنا أشرح التلقيح. When a person, when a farmer who has date palms, when he wants to the date palm, if he just allows it to grow like that, no dates come out. Or any dates that come out, you can't eat them. What the person has to do is you have a male date palm and you have a female date palm and the farmer actually takes something from the male date palm and he puts it inside the female date palm and when he does this and this is called talqih then the dates come properly and you can eat them so this is called a talqih pollination he has to pollinate the female tree with something from the male tree so مرة ثانية الآن
باع البستان بما فيه من نخل بعد أن قام بتلقيح النخل.
So now a person wants to sell a garden of date palms after he has pollinated it.
نعم. إذن باع البستان بعد التلقيح. نعم.
So now he sells this garden after pollination.
عندما جاء وقت الحصاد وقت أخذ الرطب جاء البائع. وقال هذه الثمرة لي ليست لك.
Now when the time for harvest has come, and obviously he's already sold the garden now. When the time for harvest has come, the buyer who sold the garden, he says that these dates are my possession. They're not your possession.
له هذا.
For him is that. So those dates are now for him because he sold it after pollination.
لأن هذا البائع عندما قام بالتلقيح. تعلق بهذه الثمرة نعم فالشارع الحكيم أعطاه هذه الثمرة نعم
because when this person, he went and he pollinated the date palms, he did this, and therefore his right is still attached to those dates. And therefore, the legislator, Allah, who is wise, he has given him the right to keep those dates that come at the time of the harvest.
فماذا تصنع؟
So therefore, what should a person do?
تكتب هذا في العقد عندما تشتري من إنسان شجر بستان بأكمله وبما فيه من أشجار تكتب أن كل ثمرة موجودة أو غير موجودة فهي لي أنا المشتري نعم.
So what should you do? What you should do is when you sign the contract, when you sign the contract of transaction, when you buy one tree from this person, or when you buy a garden with all of the trees in it, you say, and of course if the trees have been pollinated, you say in the contract that this garden and the trees are for you. However, when the first harvest comes and the fruit appear, then those fruits are my possession, they are for me.
نعم باعه البستان وكان هذا البستان فيه برتقال وتفاح مثلا نعم وهذا هذه الأشجار قد ظهر منها هذا البرتقال والتفاح نعم
ظهر في وقت البيع ولا بعدين
وقت البيع يعني عندما كان بينهما العقد كان البرتقال ظاهر في الأشجار وكذلك التفاح.
Let's say a person he sells this garden or this park or this orchard with the trees on there, with the trees inside. And when he's selling it, when he's selling it, when the transaction is being written down, when the contract is being drawn up, the fruits, the oranges and the apples have already appeared on the trees.
فبعد أن كتب معه العقد راجع البائع إلى البستان وأخذ هذا التفاح والبرتقال وقال هذا التفاح والبرتقال لي نعم هذا صحيح.
After he has sold this garden or sold those trees and the contract has been written, then the buyer he goes back to the person he says, as for these fruits that were already there when I sold it, then these fruits are for me. The apples and oranges are my possession. This is correct.
نعم. بعد هذا سنذكر بيع الثمار. الآن ذكرنا بيع الأصول يعني بيع الأشجار مع الأرض. نعم.
So we were talking about what we just spoke about. Then we were talking about buying and selling the actual أصول, either trees themselves. Now we're going to talk about buying and selling fruit.
نعم. الآن جاء إلى إنسان لديه بستان وهذا البستان أو هذه المزرعة فيها نخل. نعم.
A person comes to another person and this person possesses a garden or a farm with date palms.
نعم. نهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن بيع الثمار قبل بدو الصلاح. يعني لا يصح أن يبيع البرتقال أو التفاح أو التمر أو ما إلى ذلك من الثمار إلا بعد بدو الصلاح. كيف نعرف أنها صالحة للأكل؟ أن يتغير اللون أو يتغير الطعم. مفهوم؟ نعم. لأن العنب أول ما يخرج يكون مر, فإذا أصبح حلو أصبح الآن صالح وليس فيه عاهة. نعم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he forbade the selling of fruit before you know whether this fruit is ripe enough to harvest or eat. So as an example, grapes. When grapes first come out, then they are very bitter and they're not ripe enough for a person to eat. And in this situation, it's not permissible for a person to buy or sell this fruit. You can only buy or sell the fruit after you know whether the fruit is ripe and okay to eat. How do we know if the color changes or the taste changes?
نعم. طيب. المهم يطيب للأكل. يصلح للأكل. نعم.
The most important thing is that the fruit is okay and appropriate to be eaten.
نعم. إذا كان يصلح للأكل يصح البيع وإلا فالبيع محرم.
So if it's ripe enough for a person to eat, then we say that the transaction is correct. However, buying fruit before it's ripe enough to eat, then the transaction is not correct.
نعم. الآن يا أخوانا في الغالب أن الإنسان يتمنى ما في أيدي الآخرين. يعني أنظر إلى سيارة هذا أتمنى أن لي هذه السيارة. إلى الجهاز آيفون أتمنى أن يكون لي هذا الآيفون. هذا في الغالب. نعم.
in most cases, people, they always look to what is in the possession of others. So, and you always desire what is in the possession of other people. You look that this person's got a particular car, you want that car. You look that this person's got a particular phone, an iPhone 5, you want this his iPhone or something similar.
وفي الغالب أنه يريد شراء هذه الأشياء.
And in most cases, the person wants to buy or the person wants to sell these products.
وقد يكون لديه شيء من الاستعجال. عجلة.
نعم.
يعني يستعجل لا يفكر يعني قبل الشراء.
And sometimes a person he might be hasty in buying something.
أو قد يكون الاستعجال كذلك من البائع.
Or sometimes the hastiness it might be from the buyer or the seller. The hastiness might be from the buyer or the seller.
فالله سبحانه وتعالى أعطى البائع والمشتري كذلك أنه يختار أنه يمضي البيع أو يرد البيع، وهذا ما يسميه الفقهاء بالخيار، يعني بعد أن يقع العقد يقول بعت والثاني يقول اشتريت، لهم فترة يسميها الفقهاء بالخيار، يعني يختار البائع والمشتري أن يمضي هذا البيع أو يرد البيع. نعم.
In Islam, in Sharia, the fuqaha they have mentioned that after somebody has completed a transaction, after you've bought something and the person has sold something, this person says, I am content and I've bought this thing. And the seller, he says, I am content and I've sold this thing for a particular price. And the things have been exchanged. Then there's something which the fuqaha term as al-khiyar, meaning there is a period of time in which there's a guarantee of return.
نعم وهذا الخيار له أنواع.
And this period of time, this guarantee of return, it's different types.
الأول خيار المجلس.
Firstly, the right to return that product or that transaction in the same sitting or the same gathering.
نعم هذا إذا كان البائع المشتري في مكان واحد فلهم الخيار ما لم يتفرقا. يعني الآن حصل البيع والشراء في سيارة، في دكان، في غرفة، في فندق. عندما يكونوا مجتمعين بأبدانهم لهم الخيار، إذا تفرق انتهى وقت الخيار. نعم.
So one type is when both the buyer and seller they still physically still together in the same place. So for example, if a transaction took place in a car, the thing has been bought and sold and exchanged and the contract has been signed, but you're both still sitting in the car or in the same hotel room or in the same house or the same room. As long as you don't physically leave each other and depart, then you still have a right of return for those products.
لكن إن تحايل أحدهما على الآخر وقصد بالخروج إسقاط الخيار عن الآخر لم يسقط عنه. نعم.
However, if a person was deceptive and as a trick he pretended to leave that place just in order for the right of return to be annulled, then that right of return still remains.
نعم. كذلك لدينا الآن أنواع من الخيار أخرى غير خيار المجلس. نعم.
And also we have different types of rights of return other than the right of return within one gathering, within one sitting.
أخذنا فيما تقدم الخيار عند الذي يأتي من البادية ولا يعرف الأسعار ويبيع، فله الخيار بعد أن يدخل المدينة أن يمضي البيع أو يرد البيع. نعم.
We've already mentioned the other right of return, and that is what we call تلقي الجلب, whereby a person comes, a farmer, a Bedouin from far away, from outside the city, and a person from the city goes out to him, meets him on the road, and then sells him for an inflated price. Then this person has the right to, when he comes into the city, to either return the thing or accept the transaction. This is another type of right of return.
كذلك خيار الشرط، يعني يشترط البائع على المشتري، يقول أشترط أن أستعمل هذا الجوال مدة 24 ساعة لي أن أرجع في هذه 24 ساعة، إذا مضى الوقت فليس لي الخيار. هذا يسميه الفقهاء خيار الشرط، أن يشترط عليه مدة معلومة. نعم.
And then you have another type of right of return, and this is a conditional right of return, meaning it's the condition that the buyer or the seller stipulates within the contract, i.e. a person says that I'm buying this phone off you with the condition that I have 24 hours to use it and check it and see what it's like. So the person has 24 hours within to either fulfill the transaction, keep the phone, or return the phone if he wants. So this is what they call خيار الشرط.
يعني يشترط البائع أو المشتري شرط فيه وقت للخيار. نعم مدة معلومة.
I the buyer and the seller, the buyer or the seller, they stipulate a condition in which there is a specific period of time, and that period of time is known, a quantifiable, in which they can return the product or another transaction.
ثم بعد هذا خيار العيب. يعني يشتري الآن سيارة BMW من الشركة المصنعة. ثم بعد أن يمشي بهذه السيارة يجد فيها عيب في التصنيع. فالآن يرجع للشركة ويقول هذا عيب في التصنيع. وأنتم كتبتم لي ضمان أن هذه السيارة نضمنها 3 سنوات أو ما إلى ذلك. نعم.
And then we have another type of right of return, and it is called خيار العيب. A right of return due to a defect. As an example, a person goes to the factory, to the manufacturer, and buys a BMW from the manufacturer. And this BMW has a 3-year guarantee that we guarantee that there is no defect, or there will be no defect in the manufacture of this car for 3 years. If he finds a defect in the car, then he can go back and he can utilize this right of return due to the defect in the period that was stated.
يعني مثلا اشتري جهاز سامسونج الآن.
So for example a person buys a Samsung phone.
ثم يجد فيه أن الرسائل مثلا لا تفتح مثلا أو لا يقوم يعني لا يعمل مثلا البلوتوث مثلا. فهذا عيب في التصنيع. فيرجع للشركة ويلزم الشركة أن تصلح هذا الخلل لأن هذا عيب في التصنيع. نعم.
A person buys a Samsung phone and then after a while he sees that this Samsung phone is not receiving messages, for example, or the Bluetooth isn't working, for example. This person now has the right to take this Samsung back to the manufacturer of the company and give it back to them, or that they fix the problem in that which he has bought.
بعد هذا خيار الغبن يعني يغبن أي أن يزاد عليه في السعر لكن بشرط أن يخرج عن المعتاد. يعني في العادة مثلا أن هذا الجهاز يباع ب100 باوند. قد أحيانا تجد في بعض المحلات يزيد 10 باوند 20 باوند، لكن أن يبيع إنسان هذا الجهاز ب200 باوند هذا غبن خرج عن العادة، خرج عن المألوف والمتعارف عليه بين التجار وبين الناس. نعم. فله الخيار الآن في رد البيع. No.
And then there is another type of right of return, and this is called khiyar al-ghaban, i.e. a right of return which is due to somebody being sold deceptively something with a very high inflated price. As an example, this phone is worth 100 pounds, and if you go to the different shops, and this is our custom and this is natural, this is in our society, some people are selling at 90 pounds, 100 pounds, 110 pounds, 120 pounds, So there is a level of difference in price which is accepted amongst us as being normal. Some shops are slightly more expensive than other shops. However, let's say a person sells this phone to you for £200, a totally inflated price, and you weren't aware of what the price should have been. In this situation, you have the right to now go and return this product and take your money back.
ثم بعد هذا خيار التدليس أي يدلس على المشتري. يظن المشتري أن هذه السلعة مرتفعة القيمة وفي الحقيقة منخفضة القيمة. نعم.
And then there is another خيار, another right of return, and this is due to deception. A right of return due to deception. For example, a person buys a product and it's made out as if the real value of this product is very high. This is £200.
يعني مثلا يأتي إلى السوق ببقرة. ويريد بيع هذه البقرة.
For example, a person comes to a market, to a cattle market, in order to sell a cow.
لكن يكون ترك هذه البقرة أكثر من يوم ولم يحلبها. وبهذا تأتي البقرة إلى السوق ممتلئة الضرع. يظن المشتري أنها حلبت في أول النهار وأنها حلوب وهي في الحقيقة ليس فيها حليب لكن هو جعل الحليب يجتمع أكثر من يوم مثلا. نعم.
So So as an example to this is what the Sheikh mentioned, the Fuqaha mentioned. For example, a person brings a cow to the cattle market in order to sell, and he wants to inflate the price as much as possible, or he wants to make out as if the cow is a really good cow and he gives a lot of milk. So what he does is, he doesn't milk the cow for a couple of days. And therefore, when a person sees the udder of the cow, which is full of milk, because it hasn't been milked for 2 days, he thinks that this cow is a cow which gives a lot of milk because it was milked, you know, in the morning, and yet all of this milk is still there. So therefore, this person thinks that this product that he's buying, this cow that he's buying, is very good, it gives a lot of milk, but the reality is it doesn't give much milk.
نعم. فمتى يكتشف المشتري؟ متى يكتشف هذا التدليس؟ متى يكتشف التدليس؟
So when does the person who has bought this cow, when does he become aware of this deception?
بعد أن يحلبها.
After he himself milks the cow.
ثم ينتظر أن الضاع يمتلئ فلا يمتلئ.
And then he waits for the udder to be filled with milk again, and he finds it that it's not being filled.
فله الخيار ثلاثة أيام.
Then he has a right of return for 3 days.
إن شاء أرجعها.
If he wants, he can give the cow back and take the money.
ويرجع معها صاعا من تمر مقابل الحليب الذي أخذ.
And along with the cow that he's returned, he has to also give a صاع, يعني 3 kilo.
نعم تقريبا 3 kilo.
He has to give a صاع of dates, which is approximately 3 kilos of date, along with the cow. And these three kilos of dates is in compensation for the milk which he milked and took.
نعم. هذا ما يتعلق بالبيع والخيار أنه يختار. إن انتهى وقت الخيار فليس هناك إلا الإقالة. نعم. الإقالة هي أن يأتي المشتري إلى البائع ويقول له أنا أعرف أن العقد قد تم وليس لي خيار لكن أريد الإقالة منك أن تجعل هذا البيع بيننا ينتهي الآن وتأخذ أنت السلعة وأنا يرجع إلي مالي. يستحب للمشتري أن يقيل هذا وبهذا يحصل له الأجر عند الله كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من أقال مسلما بيعته أقال الله عثرته يوم القيامة. يقول الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى في الغالب أن كل من قبل الإقالة عوض الله سبحانه وتعالى خيرا منها. نعم.
Then we have another. So these are the rights of return. And these rights of return, as mentioned, they have a specific time frame. We said a right of return in the gathering, a right of return for 3 days and so on and so forth. Once this period of the right of return has finished, then the right of return also finished. And then nobody is compelled or obligated to return or annul that transaction. However, there is another avenue of right of return, or there is another return that a person can do after the ending of the period. And this is called al-iqala. And this is that the person who has bought the product, he goes to the seller and he says that I bought this product to offer you for this amount of money. And I know that the period for my right of return, it has finished. And therefore, I don't have any right of return now. However, if you would, out of your generosity and out of your goodwill, if you would return it, you know, and this is something that is voluntary, then, you know, I would be grateful. In this situation, then it's recommended, it's mustahab, it's highly recommended for this person to return and annul that transaction. He gives him the money back and he takes the product. And Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he mentioned that in most cases, when a person, out of goodwill, as a gest of goodwill, he returns this thing, even after the right to return, then Allah replaces it with something better. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned that whoever, as a good gesture, he returns a product or annuls the transaction, then فَقَدْ أَقَالَ اللَّهُ
عَثْرَتَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. نعم. يعني ما كان عليه من ذنوب ومعاصي. نعم.
And then also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His kindness, then He forgives the sins and the acts of disobedience.
نعم. والله أعلم، صلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى صحبه وسلم.